Due to large incoming solar radiation in tropical regions, the upper layers of the Atlantic Ocean gain heat at low latitudes. Ocean currents are set in motion to redistribute this heat to higher latitudes, warming up the atmosphere along their path and contributing to mild weather conditions over Europe. This corresponds to the upper limb of the Atlantic Meridional Overturning Circulation, AMOC for short. At high latitudes, the cooled and densified surface waters descend into the ocean interior and return back south, making up the lower limb of the AMOC. Let us follow the AMOC water movement by deploying and tracking particles. Vigorous warm currents flow northward along the western boundary of the Atlantic. We start in the North Brazil Current, which first breaks up into strongly rotating circular eddies, which then feeds the flow into the Caribbean Sea. Away from the boundaries, the current velocities are weaker. In the Gulf of Mexico, the current makes a sharp turn into the Florida Straits and ends up in one of the largest current systems in the world, the Gulf Stream. Here again, energetic eddies can be seen with particles rotating for a long time around the eddy's center. Further north, the Gulf Stream continues as the weaker and less defined North Atlantic Current. Part of the flow continues into the Nordic Seas, and the other part goes around Greenland into the Labrador Sea. Along the way, the surface waters become cold and therefore dense, plunging into the deep when they become heavier than the water below, in a process called convection. They then flow southwards as they encounter water of similar densities. This forms the deep western boundary current, the lower limb of AMOC, which starts at the southern tip of Greenland and then closely follows the continental slope. At the exit of the Labrador Sea, the deep western boundary current goes around the Flemish Cap and enters the region below the Gulf Stream. The flow in the upper layers is so strong that particles deeper than 2,000 meters still feel this movement and are entangled into eddies. In contrast, directly at the boundary, currents progress slowly southwards. The flow, at depths of 2,000 meters south of the Gulf Stream eddy region, is mostly confined to the continental slope and follows the bottom topography. Along the South American continent, the continental slope is interrupted by large underwater promontories, which the deep western boundary current needs to circumvent. While going around them, meanders and eddies are generated. The flow becomes unstable. One of those regions lies in the southern hemisphere off the Brazilian coast. The deep western boundary current is disrupted into eddies and beyond there no longer flows as a well-defined current. The lower limb of the AMOC, from there onwards, is dominated by ocean eddies.